Today I'm going to be reviewing the MOVESPEED HB7450. I'm going to be comparing this drive to a few other drives on the market and running a variety of tests to see how well it stacks up. Let's first go over a quick overview of this drive. This is a PCIe Gen 4 X4 drive and it's a M.2 2280 form factor. This drive has a Maxio MAP1602A controller on board and uses YMTC TLC NAND to store the data. It is a DRAM-less drive, but it is marketed as being the high end of the DRAM-less drives, capable of over 7 gigabytes per second. This drive I have today was sent to me by MOVESPEED for review, but all of the thoughts and testing in this video was done by me, and MOVESPEED has not reviewed this video or any of my opinions before it went live on YouTube. My test system was a 12900K system, which should be able to fully take advantage of the performance of all the drives I'm using today. And I also used a fully up-to-date version of Debian 12 for doing my FIO tests. I also used a fully updated copy of Windows 11 for some of the Windows performance testing I did as well. Now let's take a look at the different tests that I ran. I ran 5 different tests. One was a sequential read, one was a sequential write, one was a low Q-depth random read, one was a low Q-depth random write, and one was a high Q-depth mixed read and write operation. All of these were done for a total of 60 seconds, and the results were averaged during that period. And here's the data here if you want to take a look at it compared to the other drives. And the MOVESPEED drive trades blows with the SN770, as expected, being a high-end DRAM-less drive. And even compared to the drive with DRAM, it looks pretty good. I don't see any major performance issues or anything to be alarmed about. But all of these drives were done with an empty drive that had been fully trimmed before each of these tests, which is not really real-world because you don't run your I/O operations like that. So I re-ran all of these tests with a filled drive so the SSD didn't have extra data to work around with, which makes it easier to do some write and read operations. So with a filled drive, you see the performance drops significantly, and these drives all struggle to hit their rated speeds and take significant performance hits. And this is kind of to be expected with almost all consumer-grade drives, as they kind of expect relatively bursty workloads, and also to have a good amount of free space to give the drive extra room to work around with. Overall, with these FIO tests, this drive did pretty well. It traded blows with the SN770, which is a other DRAM-less drive and the most similar in terms of competition, and I don't see any issues looking at these tests. Now let's take a look at sustained write performance. This drive, like almost every other consumer-grade drive on the market, has an SLC buffer. Once that buffer is filled, it'll start writing to the TLC part of the drive at much slower speeds. This drive writes for about 5 gigabytes per second for a little bit, but it fills up relatively quickly, and once that's filled, it writes at about 500 to 600 megabytes per second for nearly forever. I tried doing 20 consecutive write jobs on this drive, and it still maintained that same write speed. This drive was a little bit slower in the sustained write performance compared to the other drives I looked at, but its sustained write performance is still what I consider to be reasonable and not really an issue for a lot of workloads. I also took a look at thermal throttling and overheating of this drive. I tried running it with no sticker and almost no airflow to see if that would cause any issues or slowdowns, and it didn't appear to cause any problems, so this drive seems to be relatively good for hot environments where you don't have great cooling for your SSD and doesn't need a very big or good heatsink at all. The one interesting thing I noticed is that the self-reported temperature on this drive seems to be a little bit off, because when I compared it to a thermal camera reading, the thermal camera read much hotter temperatures on the controller and the NAND flash than the actual internal reported temperature was, so I'm not sure what that internal sensor was reading. In addition to running my FIO artificial benchmark tests, I also ran it as a Windows boot drive and just kind of played around with different applications and programs and other things to see if I could see any slowdowns or major issues. And I didn't notice anything. It ran Windows just fine, programs installed quickly, I/O seemed snappy, there was no noticeable issues or problems, and even when I tried pushing the I/O very hard in something like uncompressed video, the rest of the system didn't stutter or slow down or have any major problems. I don't see any issues running the system as a Windows boot drive, and here's some crystal disk mark if you want to take a look at a standard crystal disk mark run of this drive. Overall, this drive performs well. I didn't have any issues to note about when testing this drive. It meets all of its specifications, and it also performs similar to other drives in the same product class. So I don't really see a reason not to get it if you want to get this drive. But when it comes to what exact drive you want to pick, likely price is going to be the major factor. There are links in the video description provided by MOVESPEED if you want to take a look at the current price of the drive or purchase this drive. I also want to mention that there's other parts of a drive that I can't test just having a review sample. Things like how good the warranty is and how fast that support works, and also the failure rate of the drive. I'd also love to hear input from the viewers about what I could do better in reviews like this, what you'd like to see me do more in my testing or less of, if there's any specific test you'd like me to run on, anything I could do that would separate myself from other reviewers, and just other comments you might have about my review process in the comments below. Thanks for sharing any information or comments you have about this video and the process. And in general, thanks for watching.